You're going to fail, and I'll tell you why and what you can do to prevent it. Today, 6 reasons you can't learn to code. Hey, I'm Mark Lassoff. I teach people how to become professional developers and designers. If you're trying to learn pro-level development and design skills, please like and subscribe. So before some rando comments that I'm discouraging people, let me say that I'm an advocate. I want people to learn these skills. I think it's part of basic digital literacy. But the problem is most people fail. And if you're failing, it's not your fault. A lot of it is the way we teach people coding. And there are things you can do to increase your chance of success. But first you have to understand the problem. So let's count them down. The number 6 reason you can't learn to code is they've lied to you. Learn JavaScript in a weekend. Become a professional developer in 8 weeks. Learn to code on your free weekends and your underwear while eating a bowl of Captain Crunch. It's all bullshit. They're lying to you. You can learn the fundamentals of coding in a weekend, but it takes years to become a true developer. All of these boot camps and programs trying to get inside your wallet are making promises that are just impossible to realize in reality. Everyone learns at a different pace, and most people have other things going on in their lives besides learning to code. It's just not possible to learn to code in such a short period of time with any deep understanding that'll make you successful in the workplace. In the interest of full disclosure, I do run an online program that teaches coding, but at $10 a month, I'm not getting rich or setting any artificial timelines for completion. Reason 5, we don't teach the way humans learn. My biggest pet peeve about the way coding is taught is this. In many cases, we do the opposite of what learning theory says we should. For example, many college programs start education with Java. Your first program in Java requires you understand 11 separate coding concepts to fully grok the code. The code is both highly abstract and very complex. Unfortunately, we don't learn well when we start with abstraction and complexity. We learn when we layer abstraction and complexity over a context of experience and understanding. That's built by starting with easier, less abstract languages like Python or even HTML. Too many experienced developers see complexity as some kind of badge of honor, and that's not all that helpful to you when you're learning a language. Ignore the advice of experienced programmers. I'll bet they're going to argue with me in the comments, but if you start simple, you'll be more likely to succeed. Reason 4, you don't really like it. Coding's not for everyone. There's no law that says you have to learn coding. If you don't like it, don't do it. Look, life is short. I'm now 47, and I've resolved not to spend my time doing things I don't want to do. I don't want to work on Fridays, so I don't. I don't want to work with assholes, so I don't. You only go around once, and you can't spend your time forcing yourself to do something you don't like. Even if there's pressure on you to learn to code from your family or friends, if you don't like it, stop. This is one of those fields you have to be passionate about or you'll always be behind. Things change too quickly and there's too much relearning for you to truly manage if you're not happy. So if you don't like coding, don't even watch the rest of this video. Quit right now. Well, maybe after the video. That's a better idea. Reason 3, you're going at it alone. Coding is a team sport. It's baseball, not boxing. You need a team even if you're just learning. That team is going to be your support system when things get difficult. You need 2 types of players on your team. Those who will help you solve technical problems and those who will support you emotionally. Your technical team are the people learning beside you. When you get stuck and can't find a bug, they'll provide a second set of eyes to find your missing comma or your misspelled method name. That second set of eyes is important, by the way, and it's going to save your ass more than once. Your other team is your friends and family. They're the people who care about you and are going to help you reach your goals. They provide encouragement, coffee, and takeout while you keep plugging away at a coding problem. Their support is critical to your success. Reason 2, you have ADD, like me. If you've been watching the channel, you may have heard me refer to my adult ADD, adult attention deficit disorder. It can make learning very challenging, especially if you don't get treatment. You might have ADD if you frequently start projects but don't finish. You have trouble focusing for long periods of time, especially when stimulation is lacking. You might also have periods of hyperfocus, where you concentrate intensely. You might also be impulsive. And finally, you might have ADD if you have a low tolerance for frustration or get frustrated easily. I'm not a psychologist, but I know I was able to work with a professional to learn techniques to make my ADD easier to manage. You can too. If you suspect you might have it, get some help. It's surprisingly common. WebMD estimates 5% of adults have ADD, and the techniques you learn can make it easier for you not just to learn to code, but to succeed in life. Reason number one, you're learning how to code instead of coding. This may seem like a strange distinction, but you may be failing because you're focusing on learning syntax and detail instead of learning code to solve common problems. You learn code by coding, not by studying or reading. To learn something new, create a problem around the new knowledge. For example, if you want to learn how to use arithmetic functions, create a program that calculates the area of a triangle or a batting average. If you want to learn how to store data, create a simple contacts database. If you want to learn the Google Maps API, there are dozens of projects you can do. It's almost never too early to start working on projects, and projects are where your real learning takes place. So find a problem and go solve it. That, more than anything, will help you learn to code. So there you have it, 6 reasons you can't learn to code. Please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos on becoming a pro developer or designer. My name is Mark Lassoff. See you next time.